Neither Manila Mayor Isko Moreno nor Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte have officially bared their plans for the 2022 presidential elections. But Manila's chief executive has this to say against his Davao City counterpart. Both of them figured well in recent pre-election surveys for the presidency.
Ayaw kong pangunahan ng taong bayan sa pagpili nila na kanilang leader. But I hope they will not be called stupid later on. Hindi ako naniniwala na ang posisyon sa gobyerno minamana in a democratic government. Ang demokrasya ang taong bayan ng pumipili. Hindi ipinipilit yung mga kalahi niya pagkatapos niya na.
But for Mayor Duterte's ally, former Camarines Sur Representative Rolando Andaya Jr., Mayor Duterte is not like her father. He also ruled out a father-daughter tandem.
She is her own person. She has the name, she has the brand of Duterte, but you have to consider she grew up under the tutelage of the mother. Ibang klase ito. Ito ay vitamin fortified na Duterte.
But Andaya believes President Duterte will support his daughter should she decide to seek the presidency.
He was actually challenging this person months before when the president said hindi pang babae ang trabaho na to. That was not something meant to discourage or to tell Sara, do not run for president. It was actually a father challenging his daughter, hindi pang babae to.
Center for People Empowerment in Governance Chairperson Dr. Temario Rivera, meanwhile, doesn't think Mayor Duterte will agree to run alongside her father.
Kung tutuloy si Mayor Sara, na presidente, ano ang mangyayari sa posibleng tandem? No? Very unlikely naman na magiging tandem si Mayor Sara at ang kanyang tatay. No?
Okay.
Palagay ko Mayor Sara will be uncomfortable herself.
Okay.
At sa tingin din ng botante, masyadong garapal na yon. No?
Mayor Duterte has also rejected calls by her father's party mates to join the ruling party, PDP Laban. She is a member and leader of Davao-based political parties. Like Albay, Representative Joey Salceda, Andaya believes Mayor Duterte's presidential run is a foregone conclusion.
Well, she decided yes, but let her give her the space, give her the time to announce it in public. I know it, I have first-hand information, so I'm with them, that she is very much, or she is interested.
Andaya also reads a symbolic meaning to the COVID-19 jab that former Defense Secretary Gilbert Teodoro got in Davao. He believes Mayor Duterte intended Teodoro to be her running mate.
And that vaccine shot was very clear to us. Sara Duterte was trying to make or challenging Gilbert Teodoro be my poster boy in this problem that I'm facing now, the rising cases of COVID-19 in Mindanao. Be my poster boy, be my partner, be my vice president. Are you up to task? And he said yes. Now, if she had offered that to others, then maybe we could say na pare-pareho lang.
Mayor Isko Moreno, for his part, says he's certain about running in the 2022 elections, but has not decided on which position.
Well, ganito. Busy ako sa pagka-mayor. May obligasyon ako sa mga taga-Maynila. I would rather focus on that until the last day na magdi-decision ako. And I'm going to be fair with our people. I'm going to be honest with our people at magpapaalam ako sa kanila. Kung ano man yon, that is remain to be seen. No? But definitely, I am running.
On Facebook, opposition leader Vice President Lenny Robredo maintained she remains open to run for president, but she also has other matters to consider. Robredo says she will make an announcement once she's reached a decision. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.